Today we're having the USGBC Inland Empire chapter open house for the facility for Toyota. What was really interesting within the project is we had, during our initial studies, Toyota had in their basis of design a LEED certified building. And so to go from that basis of design and to use what we had in the facility to achieve silver and then ultimately a gold project speaks volumes. So that was pretty impressive. I think the team is very proud of that. Toyota is very proud of that.
This is a 7,000 square foot lease facility that we have out in Rancho Cucamonga that provides technical training for the local dealerships' mechanics. The reason technical training is so important nowadays, and this is more than just how to change your oil filters, is that our vehicles, everyone's vehicles, have become so complicated and sophisticated, is probably the better word for it, that it really takes quite a bit of technical knowledge to be able to diagnose it and repair it and make sure that the vehicles are performing to the satisfaction of the customer.
The project remodel consisted of trying to maintain as much of the facility that was here with remodeling it and bringing it up to date. So a lot of what was brought in are sustainable features from the carpet, the paint, everything that we have in the project is low VOC.
Typically the technical training folks really like a nice clean looking floor. In the past they've really been requesting epoxy floors. Well, epoxy floors have a lot of VOC and they're high maintenance item and they really end up costing us quite a bit. So at this facility we actually went to a polished concrete floor which utilized no VOC materials and is much easier to maintain.
All this roof, underside of roof insulation was existing. We maintained that. We used a ton of existing construction. We did minor reconfigurations during the course of construction in order to save components that were already here and reuse them. We actually brought four dumpsters rather than having just one dumpster out here. We brought four out and everything, wood, drywall, carpet, concrete, everything went into its own dumpster. They were labeled, and so all metal that was demolished, there was a lot of existing conduits and so on, all that stuff went into its own dumpster, and so we sent that to specific locations that Mark set up so we could achieve that 95% reclamation.
The sustainable route is a lot of it is how can we take better care of the limited resources we have. We can use more efficient light fixtures, but even more cost effective is turning off the lights. So the whole not using electricity, or the negawatt, as the utility companies say, is the most effective form of energy efficiency.
You know, you see we've got some skylights here. There are also, what you know, maybe don't notice, is there's sensors here so that when there's a lot of ambient light, daylight from the outside, that these sensors pick that up. And these lights are all on zone, so it shuts down power and saves energy.
As far as water use reduction, we've achieved a 40% water use reduction within the facility. The lighting power has been reduced by 30%. Some of the other sustainable features that we have is we have carpool stripe spaces specific for carpool. There weren't many site selection credits that we were able to achieve, which made it even more impressive that the team was able to achieve a LEED gold rating.
What I learned is that no one thing in the LEED certification is any more important than any other. There are so many aspects and so many points that you can achieve. It's, you know, everybody, every discipline, meaning the architect, the owners, you know, the client, the engineers, the contractor, the subcontractors, everybody, this thing is a widespread responsibility. And if everybody doesn't do their part, then it's a wasted effort.